Hi, I'm Paul Liebert, a former dancer here in the UK. I've danced with various companies. Firstly, started with London Contemporary Dance Theatre, Rhombet Dance Company, then Scottish Ballet. I've done various independent things over the years. Now I'm the teaching faculty at Rhombet School and London Studio Centre. I've been practicing when I started dance from a very young age of 9 years old, so I'd say quite fortunate for a young male dancer here in the UK. Started dance in a very funny way because it was a normal academic school in Leeds that had dance on the timetable. Nadine Senior was my first teacher, who was a former, she formed Normal School of Contemporary Dance, which is up in Leeds now. Started dance for many young dancers here in the UK, a lot of black dancers here in the UK, and who have gone globally as well. Started at 9, worked with the Health Youth Dance Group, which I, funnily enough, worked with some of the Phoenix guys as that company was being formed back then, back in the early 80s. From there, came to London at the age of 16, trained for 2 years at the place, and then got a job with the company, which was brilliant. So I joined the Contemporary Dance Theatre 5 years, having various directors, starting with Robert Colhan, then Dan Wagner, then Nancy Duncan. Then I wanted to change after 5 years there, so I went over to Rhombet one afternoon. Richard Alston gave me a job. I danced with Richard Alston, well, for a very short time because the company changed director quite soon after. Then I had Christopher Bruce for 8 years, I think it was. Then I had Mark Baldwin. Then there again, I wanted to challenge myself again because I think I was probably 35 by this age now. And I thought to myself, what do I do now? I know Ashley Page has just taken up Scottish Ballet. So I went up there, auditioned, and danced there for 6 years until 42, which is quite an old age for a dancer, still performing. I would say what I do now as a dancer, or dance teacher I should say, is I teach Graham, and funnily enough that's one of the first things that I started off with my training here in London. I trained at the place back in 1985 to 87, having teachers like Jane Dudley, Robert Colhan, Juliet Fisher, various people in the school teaching me Graham. And it's funny enough, over my years I went from this, doing more modern ballet, and reverted back to Graham many years later. Influences over the years have been various people. I'd say Bob Colhan, rest his soul, passed away earlier this year, was teacher, mentor, friend, all those things, I'd say, in 30 years. It's very funny because going to the place, him nurturing me in a very caring way. I remember he took me to the office when I was 18, just around the company. And he said to me, you're going to have a lot of attention over the years, being very dark skinned, being a black dancer. And I was very thankful for that many years later. I remember being on tour and people going up and rubbing my skin. And I thought to myself, if I hadn't been given insight into this, I would have found this difficult, I think. So I think he was very, very caring in that way. So yeah, dancing his works are wonderful. Going on, Dan Wagner, another director. Initially I thought he didn't care for me very much as a dancer, but we got on very well. He taught me very different things, taught me a different style of dancing. Went to Rhombet. Chris Bruce was a wonderful pioneer in what I did, because I say his style of work, and he also opened me up to Killian, to Naharin, to Matt Sek, to all these kind of people. Which for me, these are the things that I was dying to dance from a very young age. I remember seeing Rhombet back in when I was 13, seeing Ghost Dance, and I thought, I've got to dance this. I had this kind of burning desire that I had to do Ghost Dances. And funnily enough, many years later, I danced this, I was one of the ghosts, and it was kind of cementing what I wanted to do. Scottish Ballet there again, went to a company which Ashley Page gave me so many opportunities. there again, dancing Forsyth, dancing Balanchine, dancing Jerome Robbins, dancing works that I would never thought I would have danced in my career. But managed to do them because she was wonderful. The term black dance for me, that's a hard one, I would say. Because for me, I just say this skin that I wear is there. It's there. People see that. So if people want to call that black dance with me doing these kind of works that I've done, so be it. But I would say in the end of the day, because I'm not doing traditional African dance, Caribbean dance, I'm not doing any of these, or I haven't done these forms of dance. But I would say, yes, it is black. I am a black dancer, so if they want to put me in that category as black dance, yes, so be it. But it's a hard question. It's a hard question. So for me, being a black dancer, when I started dancing Heckles and Leeds, being black was the majority. So I would say that wasn't really something that came into my head. We had one dancer, and I'm sure he won't mind saying, but David Hughes was the minority then, being the only white dancer in the youth group. And yeah, so that really didn't, it wasn't so much in my head. In my training, not so much there again, because in my classes at school, I was there with wonderful dancers, Richard Holgate and various people over the years. And going to companies, I had great people to follow. I had Darshan Singh Buller, I had Michael Small, I had Kenneth Tharp, I had all these people. Brenda Edwards was in the company at that time, so there was people around me that were of colour. So I didn't really feel I was token or stuck out there. Going to Ron Bear again, Chris Bruce had myself, he had Sharon Ray, Amma, I should call her now, Amma Ray. Sam Smith. Yeah, so there was black dancers always in the mix, same thing with Scottish Ballet. And the weird thing about it, you go to a ballet company, you always think, oh, how are they going to use you there? But I think Ashley was very clever up there because he was always blind casting. Because in some of these, like Christmas productions, I was the father to a Japanese daughter. So it really didn't, it wasn't a thing of having to be at the same race. So that was never an issue, never an issue. So I think probably some of my inspirations over the years from seeing black dance on stage. I remember back in the early 80s, here in London doing some work with Nadine Senior. I was doing a TV show and one actually took us to the Coliseum, Dance Theatre Parlour, we're in London then, dancing the Firebird. And I think that was what gave me that burning desire to do ballet, or I could see myself doing classical ballet in some form, purely because they were all exceptional. I've seen exceptional black dancers executing, performing, being artists on stage. It was unheard of back in the early 80s. Late 70s, early 80s, I would say. Because the Royal Ballet didn't have that, ENB didn't have that. So it was wonderful to see. Wonderful to see. I mean, many things inspire me. Now being a teacher, kids that care about what they do, that love what they do, that want to challenge what they do, that inspires me. I love that in the studio now when you see people on that same, I always say to students, it's a marriage. I always meet them from day one and I say, what we do together is a marriage. So we have to give and take all the time. And I do, I just hate people just taking, being a sponge. You have to give back just as much as well. And I think when you've got that kind of building block, the two ways going, I think that inspires me in the studio. As a dancer, I just love expressing myself. I loved expressing myself. And I think I'm still in the world of dance, I'm still in the studio with people. So that passion, that love is still there. That still drives me. My inspirational collaborations over the years have been various. Oh, it's hard to pin it down, as I say, different companies have fed me with different things. So I do, I think back to, it's hard to pinpoint it. It's very hard to pinpoint. I've had many great experiences with people and with works that I've danced over the years. And they've fed me, I think, I hope that I've fed them as well. So yeah, it's a hard one to question, to answer again. Do I think there are restrictions, or was there restrictions of me as a dancer, artist? I truly can't say I don't think I had restrictions. I was given a lot of opportunities as a dancer, and I took those opportunities and ran with them each time. And I also went out and sought opportunities as well. Because as I said earlier on, when I felt I was becoming stale in the company, that's when I would like put on my shoes, go to another company and say, have you got a job for me? Because yeah, I always want to challenge myself, and I think that's important. For me, it was very important. See, for black dance, I think it's very important because I think we need to know about people that have gone before us. And I look at my history, it's very limited as well, I would say. I think I'm opening myself up now that I'm a facilitator. I presume I am educated in myself now as well. I have known Namron, and I say there's people that I've worked with over the years that I can mention. Here in the UK, a lot less, because we always hear from America. We always hear a lot from America, and I think if we celebrate more here in the UK, would we entice people in more? I hope so. Would we attract people? I hope so. So having a legacy, I think, is very important. So legacy, what do I want to remember, to leave behind? It's a hard one, because then again, I'm the kind of, my nature is not to blow my own trumpet, is not to kind of big up myself, if you want to call it that. But I just hope my legacy is that I've inspired kids, inspired people to get to dance. I've had a couple of letters over the years where kids have said, yeah, I saw you on stage, you inspired me to dance. And I hope I've done that, whether it's one person, two people, 10 people. I hope I've done that. And right now in the studio, I hope I'm bequeathing my knowledge, my experiences with the people that I work with right now. So they are having a taste of what I've done, and hopefully they can build on that and grow themselves. And I would say right now, with what we've been through with the pandemic, I've kind of put things quiet for the moment, because it's been a hard year, it's been a stressful year, working on Zoom, trying to navigate your personal life, your working life. So yeah, as I say, I'm the kind of person is that one day I wake up, I hate looking in the future saying I'm going to do this in a year, I'm going to do this in 5 years. I haven't got that kind of mentality. So at the moment, I'm just saying I'm very happy with what I do right now. And yes, I'll see. Because I say maybe next month I might say, yeah, I've got to do this. And that's when I pick up sticks and write, I'm going to do this. I'm very spontaneous in that way. So yeah, I wouldn't say I'm going to say what I'm going to do in the future.